Hi, Hiyu here. Today, I want to talk about rocket science, because I really like rocket science, and it's not the hardest thing to explain. So why do we need a rocket in the first place? Why can't you just get a plane, fuel it up, and go to Mars?
Well, you need a liquid oxidizer or some kind of oxidizer that you can carry, because there's no air in space, and you need oxygen to burn stuff, and you need to burn stuff to actually get stuff to come out the engine of the rocket.
So here's the next hard part about rockets. When you're taking a lot of fuel, you also have to take it with you. You have to lift it as well as the rest of your rocket. So it might not make sense to take your whole master fuel tank with you all the way to the top. That's why you have stuff like the Saturn V, where you have this part, which is only meant to carry the fuel for this part, which is only meant to carry the fuel for this part, and this part is only meant to carry the fuel for this tiny part at the top. Think of a rocket as like a lot of smaller rockets, so that they can carry the fuel for the even smaller rockets to get to where they need to go. Okay, now let's talk about rocket engines. There's two main different kinds of rocket engines. I mean, there's a few, but let's talk about the two main ones. You have solid propellants, which is like a big tube where you have just a bunch of powder and glue, basically. And the powder contains the oxidizer and the fuel. So if you think of the space shuttle, it's the two big white sticks on the side. But if you think of the space shuttle itself, it has these little engines on it. Well, they're really big engines, actually. These are liquid engines. They use liquid fuel and liquid oxidizer. Now let's talk about specific impulse. Specific impulse can look kind of complicated, but it's really just about the efficiency of your fuel and engine combination. So some of the most efficient rocket fuels out there don't produce much thrust most of the time, so they're really only useful in space. However, some of the less efficient ones can be really explosive, so are really useful for getting off the ground when you're having to fight gravity. So the goal with rocket engine design is to use the most efficient fuel, but also produce as much thrust as you need for the current goal. But where do we go in space? And how do we stay there?
Well, if you just go up to space, you're gonna come straight down because the gravity there is about the same. You actually have to go sideways to stay in space because you're always falling, but you're never hitting the Earth because you're curving around because the Earth is curved.
So let's talk about the design of liquid rocket engines. In a liquid rocket engine, we start off with the injector, which is a plate at the top with lots of little holes, like a shower head. And it makes the fuel and oxidizer come out in like little streams. The idea is that we combine and mix these streams inside an area called the combustion chamber, which is where all the fire happens. So you have all this fire in the combustion chamber at a really high pressure, but it still needs to go somewhere so that you can push your rocket in the other direction. So what you need is an engine bell. So the engine nozzle, which is usually shaped like a big bell, is where all the fire comes out and we let it expand so that it reaches the same pressure as whatever's outside. When it matches the pressure of the atmosphere, or maybe we try to get it to as low a pressure as possible when you're in space, that's when you have the ideal efficiency of the stuff coming out of your engine. If our nozzle's too small for the pressure outside, what happens is all the gas comes out on fire, but then expands even more once it's outside your engine, so we're not using all that energy. But if your nozzle's too big, then the gas isn't expanded enough when it reaches the atmosphere, so that atmosphere starts trying to dig inside of it and starts disrupting the flow of your exhaust, and that can really mess up your engine. Now don't get me wrong, you still want the gas to be very high velocity as it comes out, but you want it to match the same pressure. In space, we can't really match vacuum, but we could do a pretty good job with a huge nozzle. And that's nozzle, not nozzles. So, whew, that's a lot of science. What are we actually gonna do with all this science? Are we going back to the moon? Like we did in the 1960s, and we did. We really did. I mean, you'd think someone would have caught us if we hadn't. Isn't space dead? Are we not going anywhere anymore? Well, that's where you're wrong, kiddo. A bunch of companies instead of governments are thinking of going out and doing things on their own because they're getting tired of everyone taking too much time. We have SpaceX with their BFR, which stands for Big Hecking Rocket, and they're gonna take that huge rocket, which they're gonna start building next year, and they're gonna send it to places like the moon and Mars. They'll only send it to the moon if people pay them to, but they really want to get sent to Mars. And the main reason they want to send it to Mars is because it's cool. Really, that's the only reason. There are some other companies too, but to learn about them, I highly recommend you check out TMRO. It's a really good show if you're starting to get interested in space. They do a lot of news and a lot of interviews and a lot of other stuff regarding the space industry and how it is today and how it'll be in the future. Thanks for watching. If you subscribe, you'll probably see videos coming out every now and then. We're thinking of doing some public fursuiting in Stockholm, so that'll be pretty fun. Until next time, bye!